MISIS Information Service Engineering, Lecture Number 5, Natural Language Processing, Part 4. This is the second part of speech tagging. So, we have learned already in the first part of this part of speech tagging lecture what part of speech are. We are talking about classes of words, categories of words, which have a similar meaning or a similar role in a sentence. And the point is, we want to find out how to determine what kind or what category these words are. For that, we have learned first that there are certain specific classes, the so-called POS classes or POS tag sets that are used to annotate exactly each single word in a sentence. And we have learned about POS tagging, which is the process of assigning a POS tag to each single word in a running text. Okay. Let's continue. POS tags. You remember the Brown corpus, we have there identified 45 tags in this popular tag set. The problem with these tags is that many words, here for example also in the Brown corpus, they are ambiguous. So for example, if you look at that, how many words are there that are unambiguous, that only are tagged with one specific POS tag? In the Brown corpus, there are 38,000 different words that are unambiguous. However, more than 8,000 are ambiguous, which means we have more than 6,000 which can be assigned two different tags, more than 1,000 which can be assigned three tags, 357 which can be assigned four. And there are even words, like for example here, you see seven tags for six words, well, set, round, open, fit, down, eight tags for four words, apostrophe S, half, back, A, or nine tags even for three words, that, more, or in. So we have somehow to keep up and to tackle this kind of ambiguity. However, you see there are lots of words which are unambiguous. So a vanilla baseline method could look the following way. So first of all, we are tagging unambiguous words with the correct label. We are simply using a dictionary for that. Then, if it comes to ambiguous words, what we know from corpus statistics usually is, you know, what's the most frequent label assigned to that specific word. And we simply tag then ambiguous words with their most frequent label. And as soon as we find unknown words, we tag it as a noun. Because this is most likely, because nouns are invented most frequently. So what does that mean? Yeah, if you try to evaluate that kind of a baseline method, you already end up with an accuracy of around 90%, which is rather high. However, there are some percentages left, and of course you want to make it as perfect as possible. So state-of-the-art taggers today, mostly relying on machine learning, for example, they achieve accuracies around 97%. So this is really, really high, and you might now think, yeah, so what's the reason? So why can't they achieve 100%? So even human taggers, so the so-called ceiling of that method or of the accuracy of that method that can be achieved, humans perform around also 97% accuracy, and they also make errors, especially of course with unknown words. You might think, ah, come on, I might see, if I see a word, then I can determine in a sentence what kind of annotation it deserves. However, there seem to be disagreement among humans. Why is that so? I have a nice example from you. Probably you have heard of Lewis Carroll, famous author of Alice in Wonderland. He published in 1855 also a famous poem, The Jabberwocky. "'Twas brillig in the slithy toves, stit gyre and gimble in the wabe, all mimsy were the borogoves, and the mumraths outgrabe." So try to POS tag this. You will see that's not so easy. So the point really is, then sometimes for unknown words you make mistakes, or there is a situation where you really can't decide whether this is, you know, one class or the other. Therefore, 100% is most times out of reach. Okay, so what kind of algorithms are used then for POS tagging? On the one hand, we already have touched this, there are rule-based POS taggers. This usually is a two-step approach, so you have a dictionary or a finite state transducer, which is able to assign a list of potential tags to a word. We can do that. And then you have handwritten rules that restrict to a specific POS tag according to, you know, what kind sequence of tags or sequence of words you are looking at. The problem is you will need hundreds of these handcrafted, manually crafted rules here. Then there are, of course, stochastic, probabilistic tagging methods, which also rely partly on machine learning. One of them we will talk about is hidden Markov models later on in this lecture. There are also so-called maximum entropy Markov models, also related to machine learning. And there are transformation-based tagging methods that also apply machine learning. So usually these are combination of rule-based and stochastic tagging, and these kind of rules are learned from the data statistically, so you use machine learning for that. So stochastic or statistical methods, how does this function? There we must look at the sentence or at language from the perspective of a machine. Okay, what's the most likely sequence of tags for a given sequence of words? Let's try. So let's say we have a test corpus or a training corpus, a test corpus and a training corpus. The training corpus is already here annotated. You see it here. The machine, of course, can't read the words because it doesn't understand the words. So it looks at the words in the same way we are looking to these symbols. However, the machine knows that, you know, what's the type of the word. And we see here, for example, in the first sentence, it starts with a determiner, then comes a noun, then comes a verb, then comes another form of a verb, a determiner and a noun. Okay, now the task that the machine has to solve would be simply to determine what's the most likely tag sequence for the sentence you see below there. Okay, we can't identify the single words, what they mean. However, if we see the examples above, we could probably make out that the first symbol should be a determiner. And we might also see that from the last example, because after the determiner, the same symbols follow here in the very last sentence of the training set, like in the test set, that this might be an adjective. And the third one, you might find that also somewhere. And simply from, you know, looking at that, you can try to guess what's most likely, which kind of determiner might be assigned here. So this is a potential, let's say, interpretation. So the first sentence might be a dog is chasing a cat. The second might be a fox is running. The third, a boy is singing. And the last one would be a happy bird. So then if you have to tag a happy cat was singing, you can exactly apply the type of algorithm that we were using and trying to choose the correct tags. What you already see there, what the choosing of the tags is dependent on several things. You have to look first, of course, what kind of word do I see here and what kind of tags have already been defined or assigned to that word. That's the right word, assigned to that word. On the other hand, and the sequence of these words and also the sequence of the tags must be taken into consideration. So this also determines statistically what might be the correct assignment for a tag. And this is the basis of stochastic POS tagging. So the question is, how do we predict tags? As already said, two types of information are useful. First one is the relation between the words and the tag. So words are assigned to specific tags. If we are lucky, it's unambiguous. If we are unlucky, then probably we have several tags that might be assigned to one single word. On the other hand, you have relations between a sequence of tags, which means between tags and other tags, like for example, determiner precedes noun, or determiner precedes adjective precedes noun. So these kind of sequences you have, and these you take into account. So you can make the following experiment. We already have seen in this lecture here the Google Ngram corpus and the Ngram viewer. Again here, I have an example and I have a link where you can try out this. In the Ngram viewer, you are not only able to see, let's say, the frequency distribution, how words occurred or sequences of words, n-grams occurred over time. You can also use part of speech tags because this corpus for a large part has been annotated. So therefore you might find out how likely was then in this corpus, let's say, the occurrence of an adjective followed by a noun or an adverb followed by a verb versus the likelihood that an adverb has been followed by a noun, which is usually rather unlikely, as you see here. So most likely after an adjective, there might follow a noun. So simply you can see that by statistics. Try it out. Okay, now the question is, how can we resolve POS tag ambiguity? Our decisions must be based on current observation. So we see in the corpus that a word, of course, the, might be always a determiner. Then also we have things like we can see prefixes and suffixes, which determine that a specific word, if a specific prefix occurs, like an or able, that this might be, for example, an adjective. You might take into account that the word occurs as a lowercase word. So if new occurs as a lowercase, then it might also be an adjective. Or you look at the word shape for these interesting word compositions like 35 years old. So you have there a digit and then you have an alphanumeric and an alphanumeric. And if this is then separated or put together via a dash, that might also be an adjective. So this is current observation that you make on the words themselves. And you look at then at the surrounding, at the context, and there you look, for example, at the preceding words and the succeeding words. So what's behind, what's in front of these words. And also you should take into account previous decisions. So which tags did I already see? Now this sequence of tags might determine what's the next tag following. Taking all this into account, we try now to make use of a stochastic model here, and this will be then the hidden Markov model. So what we are going to do, the problem we are going to solve, is we try to find the best sequence of tags that we want to assign that corresponds to a sequence of observations, and what we observe is here a sequence of words. So we have here the words "she promised to back the bill," and what we want to have then is a sequence of tags. This is our outset. Viewing this probabilistically, so we are considering all possible sequences of tags and we are choosing the tag sequence from this universe of sequences which is most probable given the observation sequence. And you put it that way, that you write here, you want to have here T hat. Hat means our estimate of the best one, so we want to optimize this tag sequence. And how do we do that? By choosing the x in that way that the formula we see here, so this is then the probability of this conditional probability that a specific tag sequence occurs under a given observation, that this probability is maximized. So this is the problem we set to solve. And you solve this usually, again, using the Bayes rule. We have already seen this. So what we are doing here for conditional probability, we simply try then to fill in the Bayes rule, which means then, of course, I can here write here the probability that a specific tag sequence occurs under a given observation of words equals to the probability that a specific word sequence occurs given a specific tag sequence times this, the probability that this tag sequence occurs, divided by the probability that this word sequence occurs. And since we are going to maximize here the probability, we can leave out the denominator, so this can be neglected since probabilities for all possible tag sequence for the same observation here are computed and maximized. So the denominator of all potential sequences of tags is the same, and you can simply leave it out there. And what you do here is you try then to maximize the probability here by the likelihood of the occurrence of the word sequence times here the probability of the tag sequence. So this is then the prior probability that you fill in here. Okay, and you are going to solve this again, making this stuff easier with the help of the Markov assumption. So here you find out, okay, if we try to approximate a given word sequence under the assumption that we have a specific tag sequence, this only depends, of course, then on its POS tag, independent of other words. So we are only dependent here of this observation of given POS tags. On the other hand, if we want to approximate here the tag sequence, this only depends on previous POS tag, for example, on a bigram and nothing else. So this is then the Markov assumption that we do here. So putting it together, this is quite easy. So the first one, what we have here, this is the so-called emission probability. So the likelihood or that, you know, a specific word sequence occurs for a given tag sequence. And we have the so-called transmission probability. So which tag follows another tag? So that's the transmission probability. Putting things together, a hidden Markov model could look the following way. So for example, when you start, or if you start with a determiner, you know, and there the emission probability is, for example, so this is a determiner, which is then most likely the word that follows. So determiner in, let's say, 20% of the cases is a, 50% of the cases is the, and then you have also probabilities for every sum and none. And then you look, okay, after a determiner, usually there comes either, let's say, an adjective or a noun. And this is the transition probability. So the with a probability, let's say, of 70%, an adjective follows. And with a probability of 30%, a noun follows. And again, of course, this adjective then could be one of many. So therefore, here the emission probabilities are rather low. And also for the nouns, of course, can be even more. And therefore, the emission probabilities of these nouns is even smaller. And simply by taking into account this kind of model, using the Markov assumption, and then again using these probabilities as emission and transition probabilities, you might be able to find, let's say, or to maximize exactly a text, the probability for a specific tag sequence matching a given observation of word sequences. So this is the task that you are solving with hidden Markov models. And even here now with hidden Markov models, you are able to achieve accuracies of 94-95%. So they are really good. So they are almost as good as the state of the art right now. So we don't go deeper into that. If you are interested in state of the art part of speech tagging, we have provided links for you where you can deepen your knowledge in that. And the next thing that we will talk about here in the natural language processing part of the lecture are word embeddings. So this is a rather contemporary and current topic, which is rather popular, because what you do there is, with the help of word embeddings, you put the semantics of words that you see in a language into a vector space. So each single word, or also sequences of words, might have a representation in a vector space while keeping the semantics of the words, which means you can then, for example, leverage proximity for similarity. And this, of course, is a really nice feature, and we will talk about that in the next part of the lecture.